as I explained before, parity of weights of feet, parity of weight space. Then we have this move, the composition. Yeah. Chi, where chi are modules admitting given certain operator chi. So, and what we would like to figure out if those are really the blocks that do not decompose further, this is true. And second, we would like to see when such blocks are equivalent as abelian categories. So let me start from the theorem. So first of all, yes, this is true, but any two reducible modules are linked to these blocks. Or maybe I should say it's decomposable. Yes, I forgot to say one more definition. I call the block principle. Principle block is the one which contains trivial representation. So the theorem now goes like this. Or OSP 2P plus 2. So here, in fact, here in fact, the degree of atypicality provides you two possibilities for the block. Those two blocks are not equivalent as a bigger cutting. And finally, for exceptional,
this choice just depends on lambda, right?
On yes, chi. on chi. This choice just depends on chi. And for exceptional super algebras, which are D2 1 alpha, AG2 or AG3. There are two possibilities. Any atypical block, of course. So in this case, I remind you, the defect is 1. So the maximal atypical block is just simply atypical block. And so when we have a block at chi, so if chi is not typical, then f chi is equivalent to principal block. One of the principal blocks. Either SL11 or 011, I should say 011 or OSP32. Again, here we have dichotomy, and really in each of these cases we have dichotomy. Either this block or this block. So the last part of this proof actually done by T2 1 alpha was done by Germany. And two others were done in the dissertation of my student lady Marty Rassel. Only for GLMM, the proof regardless a little. So there's some combinatorics involved, and I think it's better if I explain this combinatoric for GLMM in detail, and then just say a few words how to do it in other cases. But before I proceed to prove this theorem, I would like to make two remarks. So first of all, of course, you can answer the same question. Course, you can ask the same question for the category O.
But yeah, before you go to the category O, one case is missing. Defect zero for exceptional.
I'm sorry, defect zero is a typical, right? And as we discussed before, the typical block finding dimensional representations has only one module, one simple module. So it is semi-simple. So in this case is trivial. This is always true for all possible modules. Okay, so I remind you that typical is always semi-simple with one simple object. Simple object. That in the category O, what we do know in the usual case, what we always can reduce is sort of to some parabolic degenerate blocks and the principal block of category O. So this is completely wrong in super case. And degree of atypicality of the block doesn't say you much about the structure. So actually, I was just recently discovered it working on this with Karen Colombier, but in this case, for category O, infinitely maybe, non-equivalent. Blocks. degree of inequality.
Combined,
no, just for an algebra. I will explain more. Just keep it there. And so 1, 3, for example, and I will call it an integral. Integrals are perfect. And then I have infinitely many. Infinitely many blocks of particularity 1. So you see the difference in fact in OSP3. In SL 1-3, if I look at finite dimensional blocks, I basically have only one identical block, and they are all equivalent. And for category O, I have infinitely many of them, they are all different. So what I'm saying basically, that this is an open question. No, to classify these blocks. Yes, question.
The block means the generalized the infinitesimal character.
Generalized infinitesimal character, exactly, the same here. Yes. So what we do know, if it is regular block, and the usual.
Wait a second. Okay is generalized.
Okay.
Then you put spring or chi in smaller blocks, right?
Okay. So if chi is integral, there is no splitting. Well, like in the usual case, right? If your weight is non-integral, you can reduce it to integral weights first. But when you have an integral weight, if you have an integral central character, and you have then generalized character gives you the composable block. And I'm talking basically about those fields. In contrast with the usual case, I still don't know when such blocks are equivalent, basically, what else. And it seems like a hard problem.
And does it look like tame or wild problem?
I don't know. Okay. So, second thing, I want to discuss a little bit a typicality one case. Yes, I can, and I mention it right now. So the typicality one case, I do have OSP, if you look at this theorem, when I have OSP 4-2, OSP 3-2, and because this is this case, it equals 1. Basically. And GL11. And in principle, I can also have OSP 1-2. Oh no, OSP 2-2. But this is an exercise that I should give you before. The exercise is that this algebra is a super algebra, it's isomorphic to GL12. And SL12 can be reduced again to GL11. So what is clearly actually the article for blocks here and here I'm talking about are all equivalent. term, basically there are two blocks in this case. And those blocks are simple enough. They are actually tame. So I can classify them.
Are you discussing F blocks or O blocks?
I'm discussing only F blocks right now, okay? Forget about O blocks because I don't know much about them. I just tell you all I can say about. Now I'm talking only about F blocks. And actually this is now the theorem. You the way that the calculations of all these people that the only tame block are the laws of particularity one. So it was for a long time the conjecture of Germany. But after calculation of elite of this exceptional system, this is not here. So I can describe those blocks in terms of Weber and relations. There are equivalent for certain blocks of representations, finite dimensional representations of certain infinite Weavers. I'm going to give you now the proof.
Sorry, I don't understand what you mean by the only blocks are those over the one. I will put one.
Of a typicality one. I forgot to write down one. Thank you very much. A typicality one. Senior typical block. I call the laws.
And what's the meaning of a tame?
Tame. Okay. So there is a certain dichotomy in representation theory. So very roughly, tame means that you can describe in the composable modules and they depend on finitely many parameters. And wild means that there are in the composable representation depending on infinitely many parameters, like two matrices in space, or something like this. So this is the notion for representation theory of algebras, associative algebras. So it means that I can describe in the composable modules. All of them. And so there are only two tame Weavers associated with representation of algebras. And one of them looks like A and B. So just infinite line. And I'm going to write down AI. DI. And so this is a German book. And I'm going to write down the relations. So the relations are as follows. AI, DI, going this way equals to going the other way around. And then you move in the same direction twice, you get zero. Okay? And so this is, if you take the finite part of it, this is so-called Gelfand, one of the Gelfand model Weavers which you have to take. So this is the first case. And for the second case, you're going to have an infinite Encke diagram of type D. Here at the fourth, so I have A0, 0, Plus the relations at the fork, so I actually have at the fork I have A1, B1 equals A0, B0, A2 equals 0, B2 equals 0. Okay, so those are all relations which we have. So I would like to explain a little bit another thing about super dimension. So in this case, the super dimension alternate plus minus one, plus one, minus one, plus one, minus one. And so it is kind of interesting that the super dimension on the blocks is really a locally constant function. It's constant everywhere outside sort of finite set. And in this particular case, for example, here and here I have one, one, super dimension one. Here minus two, two, minus two, two, etc. So this sort of question.
The super dimension of the simple module corresponding to the set?
Yes, this is a super dimension of a simple module. It's a kind of interesting numbers which appear when you go to other blocks. You have a situation much more complicated.
I don't understand your last name. I don't understand your last name.
So I'm saying, the last claim about, so for almost all irreducible representations in the block, super dimension is the same. This is a general claim, but this is, I'm not sure I have time to explain this, to prove this claim, although it's not so difficult, but in this case I'm just showing you. When I say is the same, it's up to plus minus. Right, because you see the switch of parity rows this way. So each of these rows actually gives you the switch of parity in super dimension. So one of the rules is, right, if you look at the graph and look at all which are next on the left, the total super dimension must be zero. Okay. So another thing which is different comes from geometry here.
But Vera, what is the representation of this infinite?
Okay, so I claim that the block is equivalent to representations of these quivers, which I described, but...
So what is the representation?
What is the representation of the quiver?
Finite
dimensional representations. Is equivalent so you see all my quiver is infinite, I'm considering only finite dimension
of every point or the total dimension?
Total dimensions. Finite dimension total. Okay, more, maybe more questions? Okay, if not, I'm going now to move and prove a theorem for GLMI. Yes, I wanted to mention one more factor, the last factor about this, which comes from geometry. So this is the question about... if I recall again the Borel-Velport theorem, well, in the first case, I have only H0, nothing else. And here, well, by lambda, I mean the weight of the corresponding representation. But here, in fact, over there and over there, I have cohomology NH0 and H1. So for example, I can actually tell you who this. This is the trivial representation of OSP32, and this is the standard representation of OSP32. And the first thing which is slightly different and not like a classical brain theorem is here. So for example, if I just take HI G mod B, and actually in this moment there are two choices of B, but it doesn't really matter in this case. Of the trivial module, for example, of O. So
yeah,
it means yes.
I think you have your chi fixed now.
Chi is fixed, I'm talking.
Okay, what about lambda?
Lambda right here, so all this lambda admit the same character chi, the same infinitesimal character chi.
So the vertices of the graph enumerate lambda, right?
Anyway, you can enumerate vertices by highest weights of your representation. So what I'm going to say, at here, for example, I look at this vertex, which corresponds to
G. What is G?
G in this case is OSP32, for example. G is the group corresponding to supergroup. The supergroup corresponding to this.
What does it mean, it's like a variety of our supergroup?
Okay. So what is up? I'm sorry, Karagar. I explained it last lecture, but
I
can explain just a little bit. It's, yes, so you have a usual plug, right? But on this you have a shift. Yes, but this shift is not the shift of a vector bundle. It is some more complicated shift.
Okay.
This is basic. Yes. So for example, here I have a trivial representation in the V0, and I have the standard representation of E, or K32, in the V1. Okay? So there is some discrepancy. Whenever I pick up line bundle associated with any weight here, I have only sections and no highest cohomology, but here I have cohomology in 0 and in 1.
Excuse me, in your notation, O in that case is?
O is just a structure shift.
Okay, structure shift.
Yeah, or just the same as I start with the trivial representation. So let me now start proving theorem for Jelen. Thank you. can multiply this by t. This is the super trace representation, and t could be anything. And I can twist, make them all integers, but even no, in fact. So what I'm basically trying to say, that if I want to consider a typical lambda, for a typical lambda, it is sufficient to consider the coefficients which are all integers. Because I can shift by this, I add this one dimension. It suffices. All this ci and ga are fed. And therefore, I can talk about representation of the corresponding super. So actually, my issue. And therefore, I can apply a little bit of the geometry which I need here. So let me study representations of the supergroup instead of the supergroup. As I explained before, as soon as it is integrable over a river part, it is a representation. So the first ingredient is the translation factor. And this is an old idea coming from BGG, what you can do, you can tensor the four-dimensional representation and project on the globe. So in this particular case, the only representations we are considering are V and V star, which are natural and co-natural. Representations of two. And I can construct the functor from one block to another one, which I'm going to denote by t by theta. And what it does in sense m. Of V, and when projection on the globe the character fit. And then I can define them the same way. The one which is tensoring to the perpendicular.
I beg your pardon, could you quickly remind me of atypical?
Atypical, yeah. Certainly. Those are, if you take, so there are several definitions, but one of them, that might be the quickest one, if I have a weight, I take lambda plus rho, and I see with how many linearly independent isotropic roots is zero. And these numbers are typicality. It is also the fiber, dimension of the fiber in the Harris chapter. And No, I get both right and left. Because of the exactness and this property, translation functors might be projected to perspective. So, and then, but again, by abstract nonsense, if I have translation functor like this, then I can check that it maps reducible to reducible, and that's simple to simple. And map simple to simple and gives them bijection. So basically my idea is that I'm going to apply translation functors.
In this exercise, is it for a specific fancy one or in the general speaking?
Exercise to check all three, but this is really abstract nonsense.
I'm asking, is it explicability one only?
What explicability one? We are going now prove the general theorem for any atypicality for general. It's nothing to do with atypicality. Atypicality one was just an example before. I'm sorry. I moved to the general. Actually, now I'm going to remind you.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Uh-huh. So what's the relation between chi and theta?
Those are two characters. I mean, sometimes this functor could be zero, I don't care.
Yeah,
but sometimes it is not.
But in your exercise, when you claim they're equivalent, what's the...
Oh, no. If it's much simple to simple. If...
Oh, if it's much simple to... Oh,
sorry.
Okay. Sorry.
If, of course only in this case, of course there is a lot. Okay, I'm sorry. So I remind you, what we have class modules now. I should fix the B, the variable, and I assume that. So I remind you, in this case, we are in type 1, so we are going to be graded. So it's a little bit more involved in type 2. And then I have the parallel, the distinguished parallel, which is the parallel of the neighbor part, plus 2. And then I have cos modulus k lambda, which actually have a characterization of gamma 0.
You are in type 1 as well?
Right now, yes. My proof, I'm giving the proof only for GL and
M. So G is GL now?
M, yes.
Okay, sorry.
So it has also the Jamian distribution as the section from the And what is important, because in this case, you remember I explained that some varieties are split and one is split. This one is split. So actually I can say that gamma I, G mod B, C minus lambda, for a dominant lambda here, because I assume that lambda is dominant. It's zero for I raised to x. And so I'm saying it is really quite easy to figure out.
Gamma I, do you mean h?
No, it's my notation. It is h I j or sorry, I should put it. Yeah, thank you. You see, I do dualize, actually. I do the dualization because I want to use induced modules versus continuous. So then again, I have the following nice proposition, which is sort of also follows from general definition that if V is a G module, then gamma I G or V, say it's still out there, depends on V. So if V is really has a structure of a G module, I can take the tensor product also.
The first one is an observation that the weights of
six.
P are.
Okay, here?
Yeah, it's not.
Okay, so in the first case it's V, it's with plus and goes on minus.
It's not parallel, it's an observation, right?
Yeah. You wrote parallel.
Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, I'm so sorry. There's only one parallel. Thank you very much. Right. I observe that the weights are here and therefore.
You have to show the example H1 is 0.
Exactly. And I'm going to explain why. Because what is happened, if my lambda was dominant,
No, I understand why, but...
But there is a very small... Yeah, I'm going to explain it. So when I add such a little weight, I can go outside of the chamber. But I can sit on the wall. This is the worst case. I'm going to get non-regular weight. But if I don't have non-regular weight, if lambda plus rho with some even root is zero, when gamma I g mod p c lambda is zero, when I have an acyclic shape. Okay? So in general, the situation is more complicated because if I get outside the dominant chamber, there could be some conservation. But in this particular case, there is no. For all right.
So which particular case? When L is V?
Yes, and when it's V or V star. Okay?
It is the usual reason that the periods are at least minus one, right? The usual finding that your periods are at least minus one, and when they are minus one, you are punishing for the protective line.
Exactly.
Right?
Yes.
So can you do it for some other? Usually, you know, for GRN, you do it also for the minuscule, I mean for the exterior powers. Can you do it here the same?
Actually, I can. Okay. No, there is some trick here. No, not exactly, yeah. There are some other, but not exterior power, because exterior power of an odd space is symmetric power. Yeah. But there is, could be done something. I just don't need it anymore. So, and now I want to introduce next combinatorial ingredient. Which is wave diagrams. So this is very nice invention of John Brandon and Katharina. Lambda, a dominant wave. I'm going to write down lambda plus rho. And this is the sequence of integers. Now, because I added rho. I'm going to associate with this picture, which is called wave diagram, F lambda. And you consider all the z axes, okay? So you have position 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2. Can I see whether at the moment all these positions are empty? And then I look at AI here. And for each AI, I put this symbol into position AI. And for each pj, put this symbol into position. Minus bj. So, and sometimes...
But your hash mark...
Yeah, I'm going to say it, just up position AI, number AI. It's just a position number I, the position minus bj. We are going to do example in a moment that will become clear. But the point is that might happen that two guys are going to appear in the same position, and then they are married in cross. So I can get cross. But in the end, since I have this condition over here, I am going to have the picture like this. Some of the position, finitely many of them are occupied by crosses, check left and check right. So let us do one example here. So it is useful to take the roll like this.
Can you write the positions under the symbols so we don't get confused?
Zero.
Zero, okay.
So the trick is when there are certain things, when the cross is happening, actually means that AI plus BJ, right? Before, And then it's an easy exercise to check. Before I, So, I look at the diagram. And then what I can do, I can remove the cross. So if I have a diagram, it's called F bar is the diagram of all crosses removed. And so what I'm claiming that lambda and mu belong to the same block.
And remove, you mean the irreplaceable by empty place?
So here, for example, if this is F, then F bar is going to be just this. This is F bar. Okay? So I want to guess that M mu and lambda and M mu are in the same book. If the diagrams coincide after removing cross. But only if F bar lambda the same as F bar mu. Therefore, I actually can encode the central character as well by the diagram, only with one cross, right?
So yeah, how comes that the particularity changes inside the block?
But it doesn't.
But the number of crosses is a particularity.
Oh. Yes.
When you remove a cross.
Okay, that's okay, good exercise. If I look at the cross and I see how many guys I have here, this is going to be M. And the guys which I have here is going to be M, right? So if after removing crosses I have the same diagram, that implies that they have the same number of crosses.
You should fix M
and
M.
M and M is fixed. I'm not Brian M. I thought it's good. Okay, so it's very nice combinatorial device, and we are going to use it later, after the break. 7 minutes break. And I drew here a wave diagram of the joint representation. So I have the block. So my question to you is how to get all other reducible representations of this block in terms of wave diagram. It's a question to the audience. So I have to check which of the weights have the same core diagram, right? Mm-hmm. So that means I take this diagram.
Move the cross.
This is the core diagram. And then now I have one cross to put. And I can put it everywhere, right? So you see it's like one parameter family of reducible representation. If the degree of typicality is bigger, when I do have p crosses to move around, and that gives me p parameter family, basically, of reducible representations in the block. So you see at least that there are infinitely many reducible representations in the block, right? Okay. So now one more combinatorial definition. We say that f prime diagram, we're now talking about the wave diagram, is obtained from M by a simple move by left causing the right simple move if for the left one, I move this symbol one position to the right. Or this one position to the left. vice versa for the right one.
Isn't it natural and connatural?
Yes, of course, that's going to give you the tensor information of connatural representation. So here is one second. Okay? Now, what could happen that you can split the cross? In principle, you can have a cross and you can move it and you get something like this. Right? Or you can join the cross.
Right move, right?
This is going to be right move, and this is left move. This is left move. And for example, I can get something like this, and this is going to be right move, right?
No. So left is natural.
No, left is tensing the connatural, that's what I'm saying.
Left is more in a natural direction.
Okay, so this is tensoring. We start, and this is tensoring. So, because what now I change? I just change the weight a little bit, right? I just add epsilon I or delta j. And that amounts to these changes on the diagram.
It still looks like you can see sort of change.
So like here I have, for example, 0, 0, and I have 0 minus
the left move moves this symbol in the direction of this arrow, right? So
yeah, I think it is correct. No, I'm pretty sure because this is for A1 plus epsilon.
Just follow your direction. So larger goes to the right.
I'm sure. Right now I'm sure. But check yourself. I mean, is this some combinatorial thing here? So it's essentially for the proof, I'm trying to explain how it works now. And so here is the point. If I apply R obtained, and I get his filtration by me. So, because what does it mean? that I don't change the degree of atypicality. That means that I don't split the cross and I don't make the new cross.
It will split one, make.
But I don't want right now, because I just want to preserve my typicality.
Yeah, if you preserve it, because you can still split one and three, one.
No, because I can move only one symbol. Okay, so what he's saying probably is this thing. If I do locally the diagram like this, it can go, so this is the hole, right? So I'm going to go to the diagram like this. And if I have the diagram like this,
where is zero?
Doesn't matter. This is local thing. Because I move, so this is I, this is I plus one.
Even if it doesn't matter, can you work zero? No, what's important is to mark it on the right.
Okay, so this is the same R. This is I plus 1.
This is I and I
plus 1. Okay, so what's going on here? Here, I cannot move this guy to the right, right? Because I have something which is forbidden. But instead, I can move this guy on the left. And I end up with this. So whenever I do, I'm in a linear situation. And I get exactly
the
linear situation is that if this is the condition, and I have a translation function from one block to another one. So you see what happens with the core. I just move the core, this symbol to the right.
So but the second is tensor with the dual, right? In the first example, you tensor with V, and in the second...
No, it's the same thing, because look here what I'm doing. So when I tensor with V, I either move this guy to the right, or this guy to the left. Here it is.
Okay.
So it's the same. And that gives me a one-to-one transponders of K, on the cosmos. But then, I do know what's happening with simple modules as well, because I do have the joiners.
Yeah, still your proposition is defective.
No.
Because you're just tensoring with a very small guy.
Exactly. I should say that if chi bar, if theta is obtained from f chi by simple
where do you have this? If the if part or the
assumption. So of course I should exclude the situation with so if I remove all the crosses, I still should be able to get one diagram from another by a simple move. But if there are crosses, it doesn't spoil the picture. And so now I'm saying that the same is true. So I have to work with a joint function, but it's not very difficult.
It's done.
In here. Okay. That tells me, if I work it out here, know that this functor at the joint with the bijection on K lambda, and therefore I really give me bijection on L lambda as well. So therefore,
by simple moves.
How I check at the resulting module is reducible? I just look at its highest weight vectors. And if it is only one, it is reduced. Therefore, it must be only one K lambda, which maps onto L mu. And and here, since I already know that these guys, for each class module, I have just one class module, that gives me irreducibility of the image. Of course, I have to use for this the dual statement, but because I want to use the dual function, but the dual statement is okay, so we are now.
Can you state your proposition that you have two larger errors? So what happens?
What do you mean, two larger errors?
You have symbols, larger and smaller. If you have two larger symbols far away, it looks like you can move like two different points.
No, no, just check. No. Exercise, check it. You always have only one possible point. So suppose you have this, what is your question?
Okay, so you can move one to the right and you can move another.
But I get different chords. I have to pick up only move which moves block to the block. Okay, so for example,
your proposition doesn't say that, right?
If F theta is obtained from F chi by a simple move,
yes,
and the degree of atypicality of chi is the same as the degree of
you need to add something about core to the dimension.
But it's here. Chi is the core of the diagram. This is by definition the core of the diagram.
Bar. Maybe the bar is missing, possible?
Yeah, but.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, but when you talk about character, it's really, you forget about process. It's just the same, right?
No, but then I don't understand. So the statement is true for the core, it's not true in general, that's it.
No, I'm saying.
Please remove bars there and say that the cores are equal. Is it what you're saying?
No, the cores are not equal. One core is obtained from another. What is the core? The core is an infinitesimal character.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the core of two larger cycles?
This, the core of this, F bar equals F in this case, because I don't have crosses.
Okay, so what happens if you move left cross, the left side to the right? One step.
Yeah.
Is it in the conditions of the order proposition?
Yes.
What happens if you move the right side to the right? Is it the condition of proposition?
Yes, but two different chords, right? So
but in proposition, there is nothing about chords.
But it says F bar theta is obtained from F chi bar by a simple move.
Yes, they are.
But they fixed.
I think the theta is different between the two, right?
The
theta
diagrams
is
are different. If I do another one, I get something like, if this is J, this is J plus 1. So there are two different central characters, but I fix the pair of central characters.
I don't follow. So which one is chi, which is theta?
So this is chi, this is theta. One example. This is chi, this is theta prime. There are two different.
So how can bijection?
But chi and theta are fixed. So I either state the statement for this pair. Tell me, who else doesn't understand?
I think it's clear.
No, I think it's clear, right? Because I fix the central character, right? Another point is that. I can start with the diagram, and by simple move I can get any other diagram with crosses. This is combinatorial state. So we say, if chi and theta now are some central characters, of the same archetypality degree, I can get from one to another by sequence of simple mode. Mu minus mu. implies in the positive part of the lattice. It's a linear positive, the sum of positive roots. So on the terms of the diagrams, this order is just that the crosses of the one are to the left of the crosses of the other. So in particular, that means that if some truncated block. Truncated principal block. For GLPP, here P as before the atypicality. Thank you. will induce vector bundle of G1. So I could
construct it.
A1, minus b2. And then I have here c and d, and I get up like c and d minus one. So I start with this. Now again, I have a truncated block and the principal block of GLP. Why? Because I can go on beyond this part. Okay? Because as soon as I go beyond the part here, my functor doesn't work because I have high cohomology. But if I'm in this stable situation, there is no high cohomology, and so I have an equivalence of truncated stable block and certain truncated block in the GLP. And now what I can do, it's clear. I can move non-crosses to the right as far as I want. And in this case, I can increase. So starting from any truncated block, it is equivalent to some stable block. And this one is already stable. And then I do this parabolic induction. And I get some truncated block as well. Principal block. And that's what is going on. I just have to check that in the end I can write down F chi as a union of F chi here, where mu is increasing and increasing and increasing. And here I have F naught, principal block of LPP, as the union of truncated blocks. And again, mu zero is increasing and increasing. And this is very easy to see that everything agrees with this procedure. I mean, that I can do. So this is the end of the proof. So it seems like here I didn't use much geometry. However, if I'm going to work the same way for OSP, I really need the geometry because I do not have a class model and I really need the geometric description of the code. It's just that combinatorics is a little bit harder in this case, and I should probably shouldn't explain it in the range. But we can go much further, and we are actually now going to calculate the things which we want to do in terms of weight dynamics. Next thing is calculating the multiplicities. So what we want to do, we would like to calculate the multiplicities modules in the class modules, and as I explained last time, there is a PGT reciprocity, so it's going to be equal to multiplicity of class modules in the PGT
projectable.
Or in projectable. So we are going to calculate this, and the answer now can be given in very simple way. Diagrams. So we are going to consider. So first of all, what I proved actually allows you to forget greater or less, because this equivalence of categories maps projective to projectives and cuts to cuts, and so I can only think about principal work, which is not very. But it is kind of nice.
So they cannot cross?
No crossing.
No crossing.
No crossing.
No, not that.
Thank you. Yeah. multiplicities. In the room. Okay, now, huh? I at most one. So, the category is not terrible. Okay? And it is one. The diagram of lambda can be obtained from the diagram of mu, just moving some of these crosses along the path to the right end. But now on the size transition form, just cross volume goes to the guy can be fitted by the cross volume. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with a typical situation, but here on the equals to pay down there. Of course, it's a good exercise to check one part. Now we can do it again. And when I have here, it's going to be four guys. As desired. Okay? And doing induction and combinatorics. you can get a general trick if you really like this label. Calls out. Crosses, you can easily get a sensor. Yeah, this is only two floors here. Okay? So that's really how you get it, and you can get it in general in the same way. Before I stop, I want to say two things. So this Janssen numbers, multiplicities of standard modules in projective modules, they are only 0 and 1. Where is another category where the same happens? This is a parabolic category O, for G, L, M plus N, where you have a maximum parabolic related to the Grassmannian. So is there any connection? Yes, but there is a connection, and I'm going to explain it next time. So if we take... M plus infinity, and you have the parabolic of mini part, GLM cross GL infinity, whatever it means, I'm going to explain next time what it means. And then I have GL M infinity, and the parabolic of this time. The categories which we obtain are going to be equivalent categories. Okay, so that is equivalent. So here we have parabolic. For usual, for general infinity. And here we have parabolic category one. Categories for last time. Thank you. Sorry for over time.